So here we are at the Eliaro show with the new F-Type from Jaguar. That's a fantastic car, and that goes back to the roots of the company, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, F-Type is really the ultimate expression of Jaguar's sporting DNA. And as you know, we've got a long and illustrious heritage of producing some of the most iconic sort of front-engine rear-wheel drive sports cars in the world. So, yeah, this is kind of us reclaiming the mantle as a leading player in that market.
Yeah, and the whole industry is going a little bit that way, bringing back cars from the past that were very legendary, very iconic, and bringing them back to new technology, new engineering, new design.
Yeah.
So how hard is that challenge?
Well, it's funny, I've been asked that question a lot in the last couple of days. On the one hand, it's very easy because designing, because this car is a first principles design, so we designed it from scratch, a clean sheet of paper, so we were allowed to establish absolutely perfect proportions for the car. And of course, what has better proportions than a front engine rear wheel drive two-seater sports car? So from that point of view, establishing a great looking car with great architecture and proportions was pretty easy because we could do what we wanted to do. The difficult part was acknowledging the history of the company and some of our illustrious forebearers in terms of products, but doing it in a modern way that didn't make too heavy a reference to the past, because this is a thoroughly modern design, it's thoroughly contemporary, and uses all the latest technologies. And I think it's using the technology to deliver some of the design language that makes Jaguars unique. I'll give you an example.
Okay.
The car has a very low tapering tail, and it's tapered in plan view as well. In the modern era, neither of those elements is good for aerodynamic performance.
Yeah.
You want a high square tail on the car. So to help us deliver a unique rear end aesthetic, and the rear end of the car is certainly my favorite aspect of the car.
It looks fantastic, yeah.
Yeah, we have a deploying rear spoiler.
Okay.
So when you don't need it, below sort of about 50 miles an hour, the spoiler stays flush with that lovely low tail. Above those speeds, where you need the additional downforce, the reduced drag, the spoiler deploys. So it's using technology to deliver the design language that makes a Jaguar unique.
Yeah.
But also gives the car the functional capabilities that it needs to have for a modern car.
Absolutely. So the F-Type is a great addition to already a great lineup, because you have the basically your whole lineup is brand new. I mean,
yes, yeah.
What's the oldest car now? The
The oldest car we've now got on the lineup would be the 2006 XK.
Yeah, it's not very old at all.
No, no. And that's a great position for us to be in. You know, I've been with Jaguar for 15 years, and in the 15 years I've been there, this is the first time when we've got a consistent showroom with consistent designs delivered by the same team under Ian's direction that we all feel are contemporary, homogenous, and it's making the right statements about the design for the brand.
Yeah.
So it's very important to us that we've now got a showroom that reflects our design philosophy.
Yeah, absolutely. So the F-Type is going to come we see in different options, I mean different models, right? Like different engine options.
Yeah. At launch we have a twin supercharged V6 engine available either with 340 or 380 horsepower. We also have a V8 supercharged engine, which at launch is 485 horsepower, I think. And then obviously within the Jaguar range of engines, as you can see, an XFRS, which is next to F-Type, there's a 550 horsepower V8 in that car, which at some point may well find its way into F-Type, you might imagine.
That was the next question, so you already answered.
I can't say when, but of course, obviously, we have that engine to use when we use it.
And it's a perfect car for it, I think, too.
Yeah, and the performance of F-Type, the way that it handles and so on, is a massive step forward from even XK, because the car's got near 50-50 weight distribution, so it puts its power down to the road much more effectively. Great traction, so better acceleration, greater stability in the corners. I mean, the thing for me, obviously, you spend 4 years designing a car with the team, and you kind of know what it looks like, but you don't know how it drives until we build some real ones. When myself and the design team had the opportunity to drive the cars, it was a real revelation. I said, it's a bit like meeting one of your heroes.
Yeah, I know.
And finding them to be a really nice guy. Because the car drives even better than it looks.
That's something that goes on a lot between designers and engineers. Because
Put
your imagination of how the car should look. But then the engineers are like, well, maybe there's a limitation here. And then it doesn't doesn't match completely, but this is a perfect example of good work.
Yeah, and then the vehicle engineering team at Jaguar with the design team, we work very closely and we're very closely aligned, and it's us really that decides the character of the car. So the vehicle engineering team that do all of the chassis tuning and so on, they come into the design studio very early on and see what we're doing and go, okay, it looks like that. It should drive like this.
We'll work with you.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah, from my opinion, I honestly think the car drives better than it looks.
Excellent. Well, that's a good compliment for your colleagues at engineering.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Well, Wayne Burgers, thank you very much. Designing from Jaguar, the new F-Type, here at the LA Auto Show.
My pleasure, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Esto es Autos 060, y como les digo siempre, no quiten la vista de la carretera y mantengan los oídos en Autos 060.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.